MLab is our creative education lab in our team, and critical thinking project is one of many projects we, my team and I are doing, and this really different. So I'm trying to introduce the Brain Initiative a little about what the Brain Initiative, what the Brain and Education Project in this entire Brain Initiative. As I mentioned that we are involved in this project at the last minute, and the goal of this project is to bring together the research of function of brain and how to use the knowledge of our understanding of brain to promote the education. And this project is in our university level. And this project has several different, is trying to build four different platforms, and based on these four platforms, we have already set up different detailed programs, and my team are involved in two of these platforms and projects. The platform is name of improving brain development, and other platforms is to try to brain images, collect the data of brain images, behavior data, and this is a third of the platform to design the activities and environment to improve brain development. And the fourth platform is collapse all different data of brain development into the one data base, and provide to the researchers in our entire country to do the research on the development of children. So my team focuses on the development of this platform, and the function of this platform is to from three different perspectives. The main function of this platform is to research the basic cognition of the brain, three different development: basic cognition, social cognition, and high order thinking, or high order cognition development. And in terms of the interventions, or in terms of the designs to improve the development of these different cognitions, we the design we are trying to do is cover the different levels, different kind of interventions from the curriculum to the ICT-rich environment, and all the way to the brand new technologies like AR and the virtual environment. And this design target into not only the regular or common children, but also to target to some children with special needs, like the ADHD students. And this is our this is the innovation environment we are planning, we are about to do. And one is we are trying to design and develop some situated training systems, and in these systems were technologies like virtual environment and artificial intelligence will be will be used in these systems. And also we are trying to use some educational robotics to as a learning learning agents or learning learning agents to intervene the learning process of the children. And the project is still in the planning process, and the platform is about to set up from next semester, from September. And other than the platforms and the research topics, we are also going to collect the data of the 6-year children and the 18 years college students. The first batch will be 1,000 samples, and we are preparing for this phase of data collection. And the second topic is the M Lab. Because the main goal of the Brain Initiative is to promote the brain function or promote the development of cognition. And one special need is to promote the development of high order thinking skills. And our MLab is the mission of our MLab is to develop students' high order thinking skills or core competencies. Like I remember that in this morning's talk, one of the professors also mentioned that there's different titles for core competencies for 21st century skills or whatever. So I use core competence here because the main goal of our MLab is to develop students high order or subject independent skills. And we use in order to reach this goal, we are designing a so-called STEM curriculum to help students to develop these kinds of subject independent skills or core competencies. And in order to carry out this STEM curriculum, we also work on the learning space design, and we also practice this kind of curriculum in our own undergraduate program. So in our MLab, one of the research we are doing is trying to figure out what are covered in the in this core competencies, and how can we assess or measure the core competencies, or the phrases or the keywords are using with the core competencies are listed here, and we think that creativity is commonly used, but somehow creativity may be inclusive of the following skills like collaborative, problem solving, critical thinking, educational thinking, reasoning, and there's more. So we are trying to figure out what they are somehow overlapped, and there are different methods to measure these different skills. And we are trying to work out a framework to assess creativity or assess this kind of core competencies. This is one of the research we are doing. And in addition to the framework of creativity assessment, we are also trying to find out the practical way to measure the creativity in different STEM activities, because we need to measure this creativity when students are doing problem-solving activities, trying to work out some creative design and this kind of learning process. So in terms of developing students' creativity skills or core skills, because in traditional curriculum in China, there's no absolutely no space for this curriculum, because this curriculum, they are not tested in the examinations. They are not in the official curriculum. They are not included in official curriculum, and there are very, very seldom teachers can design this kind of teaching or activities for this kind of courses. So one of the work we are doing in our MLab is providing these STEM courses for K-12 schools, and help the teachers how to use our curriculum to prepare the courses and carry out these courses in their schools, and provide service for the teachers when they do not know how to teach these totally different courses in their classrooms. So we already covered almost all levels from grade one, elementary grade one, to middle school. In order to have the schools to teach the course, we also set up the creative learning lab or innovation education lab. I don't know which one is the more appropriate expression. So this is our lab. We set this lab as a sample for schools if they are trying to set up a STEM course or have these ideas in their schools, then they can use our creative learning space as a sample to set up a lab in their schools. So we set up this lab as a sample for people. And these are tools in our lab. Because our idea is that in order to train students, in order to exploit the inner innovation of students, you need to provide the options for students. So in our department, we have undergraduate programs, and we have already practiced this kind of innovation education in our undergraduate programs. Our students, these are all our undergraduate students. In our program, students have lots of chance to participate in project, in innovative project. This is a project in our entry lab, and they can participate the entire part of our entry lab. They can participate in the a curriculum design, they can participate in helping teachers to carry out the curriculum in kids with schools, and they can participate in working with school kids to work out a design or whatever activities in our curriculum. And in this way, lots of students can not only learn knowledge from our college course, but also they can have something very unexpected to our teachers, and they have their creatives, and that is our surprise.
We'd like you a few minutes to wrap up our
undergraduate and participate in the innovation. And the last part is a very detailed project of critical thinking, and we developed a game to test or assess the critical thinking of students. And